Welcome to Gaia's Love, a podcast of brief messages to help humanity bridge the gap to the new earth. My name is Vivian Gerard. It is my delight to be a scribe for consciousness today, sharing the wisdom that flows through from Source. Here we go. Episode 385. Isn't that amazing? We are almost at 400 episodes. I mean, that's just mind-blowing sometimes. And I come back to that. First, the weather report. Here in Cincinnati, it's cold. It drops. We've had 20-degree nights over the last few days. It's so cold. And a few days ago, it was 77 degrees. And now it's cold. So I am sitting with a blanket, the heater running. It's supposed to warm up though. The sun is shining today and I think we're supposed to have warmer temperatures in the next few days. But one more little complaint from me. It's really cold. I am a summer girl and I've had enough of winter. I'm officially declaring it over. We don't need a groundhog in shadows. I am declaring winter to be done. Yeah, so let's go back to 385 episodes. It's so wild. Here's something really cool that just happened. I'm just going to jump right in. So first of all, thank you for so many of the beautiful comments that I've received about last week's episode. I'm so happy that the feeling and the vibration of it resonated in the way that it did, because after it was over, I kind of wondered, like, did I articulate that in a way that makes any sense? Because I could see it so clearly, and yet I didn't know if I was translating it well. And I'm so happy that it landed with so many of you, because it's such a powerful image and understanding of life. And so I'm really happy that it connected. Which leads me to the thing that I wanted to start with, which is, apparently, this podcast is going to platforms, streaming to platforms I had no idea about. I had the most amazing experience a couple of nights ago. I have this group called She Podcasts in Facebook that my friend told me about, April told me about. And so I joined it, and I kind of just have had it on the back radar. I've posted a couple things here or there, but I don't really actively participate. Well, as I've moved my focus in social media to Instagram, the only reason I really go to Facebook, unless it's to say happy birthday to somebody or comment on my husband's post when I want to tell him I'm proud of him. Other than that, I only go to Facebook mainly for groups. And, you know, there are a couple specific groups that I like to participate in. And so when I go to my newsfeed now, it's all group posts. You know how Facebook gives you the information you look at the most. And so I'm looking at groups, and so it keeps giving me a groups comments newsfeed. Blah, blah, blah. So the other day I popped into Facebook to post something in the Energy Gym, and this post was up from She Podcasts. And this woman said, hey, you know, maybe I'm new to this space and I shouldn't be sharing this, but I just want to find out, has anybody else heard of this link? And I'll have to put it in the description, so if someone else wants to look at it, if you have a podcast, you can also look it up. But this link takes you to a place where it shows you if your podcast is being marketed or promoted. I don't even quite understand how it all works. I need to investigate it a little bit more. But it looks like it sends your podcast to all of these different platforms, and then they're streaming in all these other places. I had no idea. I usually post it in SoundCloud, and then it forwards it directly to iTunes and Spotify for me, and then I post it over in YouTube. And that's about all that I do for, you know, sharing the podcast. And then I hardly ever really promote it or market it in any way. It's just been my space where I love to share my stories and my vibration. And I trust if it resonates, it's going to move in the way that it needs to. And energy will carry it wherever it needs to be heard. And so I don't stress over it. I just enjoy the process of it. And so when I found this link and I looked at my podcast name, it showed that it was there. And then it showed like 10 different places. I don't even know what the symbols mean. Like, you know, they have the little images like for Spotify and SoundCloud and iTunes. I'm on iHeartRadio. What? So this weekend I need to go and kind of look through all the different platforms and the links and see how this happened. But if you are listening to me on a platform other than the ones I just described that I know about, thank you. Like, how cool is that that you found your way here? And I didn't even know that I was sending my message to you over those airwaves. So that is a very fun reveal, or what did I call it to my friend the other day? I said, I'm going to start tracking delightful surprises this week. And that was a delightful surprise this week to find out that, yeah, Gaia's Love is being heard in other places than the ones I knew about. So thank you. Thank you for listening. And thank you for all of your beautiful support and validation of, you know, the messages that come through me from Source. They come through me for a reason. And I always trust, like, this is the message that needs to be shared today. And often I don't even understand the scope of it until I start talking. And then it just becomes this image or story or example or energetic transmission. And so I'm really happy that it is supporting many of you also in your journey. It's really crazy times, and like really crazy times, and people are so polarized and all over the place in opinions and lifestyles and choices. And you know, sometimes it just feels so good to receive clarity and calm, and sometimes just a laugh in the middle of what looks like just a really chaotic world. I receive that, I mean, in many ways, but I receive it in social media through this man, this incredible man. I need to remember what his name is, but his account on Instagram and Facebook is called Source Messages. And I don't even know how he showed up in my newsfeed, but he did. And then I just started reading them. So every day, that's like my source forecast. You know how you have a weather forecast and astrological forecast? I have a source forecast, and it comes from Source Messages. They're so simple, so beautiful. And the way that he just directly states truth in a few sentences, it's usually a black background with white writing, and then the amazing image of sun at the top, like a sun rising or setting at the top where it says Source Messages. It's the same image that I used on the back of, I think it was my first book. I think it was My Soul Journey and the Gaia Tribe. On the back, I have that sun setting. Maybe it's that one, or maybe it's the second one. I don't remember, but it's that moment where the sun meets the horizon and everything just merges, you know, like that's the image he uses for Source, and I love that. So if you are looking for written validation and guidance throughout your week and you do not know about Source Messages, I would absolutely check that out and see if it resonates for you. Okay, so as a little thank you gift for all of this magical expansion that happened without me even knowing about it for my podcast, I thought I would pull a card for all of us, all of you, from the Gratitude Oracle deck. It's by Angela Hartfield and the artist by Josephine Wall. My friend Claire gave this to me for my 50th birthday, and I love this. So right before I started recording, I shuffled my tarot card and my deck, and then I just randomly pulled a card for all of us. I love it so much. Here's the card. This is a little Friday gift for each of you. Hang on a moment as I try and juggle all of this. It's card number 21. It's called Imagination, and it shows this incredibly beautiful woman, angel being with this huge fancy dress, like from, you know, back in the English royalty, kind of like those fancy ballroom dresses. And then her hair is kind of dissolving behind her into flowers. The dress is like dissolving into flowers, and she's sort of looking over her shoulder down at all of the images. And then all of these stories are drawn into that part of the card. So there's like a little fairy and a little girl playing, and then a young woman who is walking in a field, it looks like, with some woman behind her. There's another group of like a mother and children at a door, and then the mailman, I think, or the sailor at the door greeting them. I mean, just all, and then there's a ship kind of going off in the horizon, swan. There's just all these beautiful stories that it's like she's looking over her shoulder and seeing all of these stories. So here's the wisdom. Card 21, imagination. A vibrant imagination is more than fantasizing and creating stories of magical beings or faraway places. It is the origin of originality and innovation. Innovation and vision can be expressed through the arts, literature, technology, and science. When you utilize your imagination, it enables you to think creatively and come up with unique solutions. It can help you cultivate resourcefulness and inspiration. You can't force your mind to be imaginative, but if you are out of the practice of using it, you can spark your imagination. Imagination can show up when you least expect it. For instance, when you focus on something else and allow a problem to simmer in the back of your mind. This may be why you find your imagination revving up when you're doing a routine task, such as washing the dishes, having a shower, or taking a walk in nature. I love this line. Imaginative people can quiet their mind chatter. Practice taking a few moments to silence your inner critic, that part of your thinking that reviews and reevaluates conversations and actions. There are exercises you can do to open your imagination. These activities include journaling, doodling, listening to instrumental music, and cooking. Regularly engage your imagination and see if you become inspired and more creative. And then she has a little description of the card, so here's what she says, and I'll post the card over in Instagram. She said, a beautifully gowned woman gazes over her shoulder. The pond below her holds a gaggle of swans, lily pads, and a couple in a rowboat. A cherub sits on a grassy mound, surrounded by flowers bursting with color. Further behind the woman, there are images of people, children, and a ship. The butterscotch color of the woman's gown is a prompt for someone who is usually shy to take action now. The swans reflect your ability to focus on your dreams and remind you of the ideas, balance, and love that you have held in your mind and heart. The rowboat is the vehicle to transport you on your life's journey. Work is needed to grow, and the water may not always be smooth, but you have the fortitude to navigate your path. The small cherub is a reminder that love is always with you. And then here's the affirmation. So this would be a beautiful thing to write in your journal and come back to over the next week. I gratefully use my imagination to visualize and manifest my dreams. Isn't that so beautiful? So you're welcome. You're welcome. How fun is that? And then the other little nugget I'm going to read to you, and then I'll stop reading, is the title for today. Here's how it works. I always love these little ways that Source brings me the nugget that I need exactly when I need it. So I was looking for music for the playlist for Quietly Listening, which was on Wednesday night. I always put together about 45 minutes of music that goes along with the energy healing that Andrea and I do at 9 o'clock on Wednesday nights every other week. And so I was trying to find something connected to self-control because that was the theme that we were tapping into. And the definition in the group that we were studying, self-control is defined as balance, giving up control. And we just had the full moon in Libra on Sunday. So it's just been this beautiful theme all week of giving up control and finding balance in doing that. And so as I was looking for songs, I knew I wanted this one by Trevor Hall called In and Through the Body. It's the song title is Blue Sky Mind. And so I was looking for that. And then right after that, it started to play Reminder. And the line by Trevor Hall that I love in that Reminder song is, my love is just a reminder, find your center. And he says it over and over, and it's so powerful. So I typed that song in, the title, into Spotify. And it pulled up a playlist called Reminder. And in that playlist were all these new songs that I hadn't heard before. So I'm working and listening to these songs. This is on Monday or Tuesday, and I'm listening to all these different songs and, you know, finding the ones that match. And then this song started to play called Walking Lightly. And it reminded me immediately of last week's podcast, the feeling of like that unstoppable flow, and how sometimes we pause and we take a rest and we pull the cover over our heads, and sometimes we're like out in the front showing everybody where to go and how to move through this unstoppable force. And the song just had the same beat, the same rhythm, the same feeling of this life force that's just carrying all of us as a humanity. And so I put it in the playlist, had just a beautiful energy healing. Andrea's so talented. And then I woke up on Thursday morning and I kept thinking about this song. So I played it on my drive and while I was running errands, played it again this morning while I was listening, while I was getting ready. And so I started thinking about it as a title for today. I'm like, well, I should really look up the words. I was thinking what I was singing was Alone Walking Lightly. And when I looked at the words, it's We're All Walking Lightly, which is very different than Alone Walking Lightly. So I'm so glad I looked up the lyrics, and I'll put that song in the description. I really encourage you to, you could even do it now, like pause and listen to the song and feel the vibration of it and then come back and hear the rest of the podcast. But here are the lyrics. It's, we're all walking lightly. We're all walking lightly. Let these moments last. Could be gone so fast. Keep walking lightly. Isn't that awesome? When you hear him singing it and you feel the beat, you're going to want to get up and start walking. Like, it's so inclusive and, oh, what would the words be? Exhilarating. Like, it just feels, it feels like unstoppable energy. Because when the song stops, you want to push play and play it all over again. So here's why it felt so relevant for me. And I'll share a few thoughts and then you can see how it resonates with you. What I was articulating last week was this belief that, you know, there's, just to summarize it quickly, there's this constant flow and movement of energy that all of us as humanity, individual humans, are contributing to the collective humanity. And so that collective momentum is going to keep moving, no matter if one individual sits down and says, I'm taking a time out, or if one individual dies and leaves and another one is born and comes in, there's still this collective life force that is carrying our human experience. And so all of the choices each one of us individually make contribute to that, to that collective life force. And we can contribute in any way that we choose to. We can contribute with fear, we can contribute with love, we can contribute with tons of activity, we can contribute by just observing and knowing that that's what we are part of. And it's all perfect. You know, there's such judgment that we all are, many of us are throwing at each other and around about each one's choices, and are they good or bad or right or wrong? Do they support the end of the world? Do they stop the end of the world? We have so many opinions, just like the imagination card said, like, stop the mind chatter, because our mind chatter just takes us into these crazy, crazy places. And often when we feel that crazy, we want to get it out of us. And so we project it and we throw it out at the world through our words and our emotions. And so that's what we end up contributing to, that unstoppable flow. Oh, right? And so this song feels like it offers a vibration that's more joyous, more present. This understanding that, you know, walk lightly. You don't actually know how many more moments you're going to choose to be here. You might think you know. We might all think that we're going to be here until we're 80, 90, 100, however old we want to be. But the soul is part of that mind-body soul trio, and we don't always understand or pay attention to what the soul is choosing for our soul's journey, for our bigger experience, not just this one lifetime here on Gaia as a human. And so the soul can opt us out if it's time. And the mind may not have been quite prepared for that. The body may or may not have been prepared for that. So perhaps the best way to live is fully in this moment, fully in this experience, this one day that you're in. You know, live it all the way. Be all in. I talked about this in the podcast a little while ago called About Time. It was, I put a spoiler in there. If you haven't watched the movie About Time, then skip over the next couple of minutes. But in that movie, he is challenged to be so present in his life that he makes the best out of every single day. He doesn't have to travel through time and go back and relive the day to make it better. He chooses each morning when he gets up to go all in and have the best experience he can have, because he doesn't know how many more of those days he will experience here. And I feel like that's such a powerful choice for us to make, to, how does he say it again? To let this moment last, because it could be gone so fast. So keep walking lightly. What if, and I don't say this from fear, I say this from love. Like, what if this is your last Friday or your last weekend? You know, what do you want to do? Like, don't hold back. Don't be afraid. Don't wait until later to tell someone something or, you know, have that experience you've been wanting to have. Why do we so often sit in fear and delay these beautiful experiences that we crave so much? You know, the card imagination is so perfect to tap into when we're talking about this. If our imagination is bringing us an image or a desire or, you know, a piece of art that we're going to create or a story we're going to write or a podcast that we're going to start, if our imagination is showing us all of these incredible things that are possible for us, why do we wait so long to allow them to take form? You know, what can we do now, today, this weekend, that brings us in the direction of that thing that we are most desiring? And I don't know what that is for you, but for me, you know, when I talked about, when I claimed as my intention at the beginning of the week with my friend, I'm like, I claim, like, it was number 4 on my list. Others were like work things. Number 4, it was, actually, they weren't all work things. There were some things there about being present with friends and family. So it wasn't all work. I had to think about that for a moment. I'm like, was it all work? No, it's not. But number 4 on my list was be open to delightful surprises. And that's what's been happening all week, just these incredible, beautiful, unexpected moments. And it's so fun. It's such a fun way to move through my week. It's such a playful way to engage with my soul and my mind and my body. Like, be ready. You know, something really cool and fun is going to happen. And then I manifest that. It happens because I set the intention, I allowed my imagination to play, I'm open to receiving, and then these amazing little moments keep carrying me. And so my engagement with this unstoppable flow of energy is this walking lightly, being so in the moment and not worrying about next month or next year or 5 years from now. It doesn't mean I don't have dreams. For that, I do very clear dreams, but once the dream becomes the image for me and I can see the possibility of it, it still serves me to be present in this moment enjoying, delighting, knowing which direction I'm going and moving towards that, but not gripping onto that future dream. I hope all that made sense. I feel like it may have been a little contradictory. It is important to know where we're going and what those dreams are that we want before we die. I think it's absolutely critical to, not critical, but powerful to have those big picture dreams and images. And then in this moment, in this day, how can your joy, your zest for life, your enthusiasm for this experience line up with that dream? But you're not in the future trying to get the dream. You're here in the moment, enjoying the moment, allowing all of the magic to carry you towards that dream, but moving forward, you know, making movement towards that thing. I'm going to trust that all landed. It gets confusing sometimes. It does get confusing because I feel like we're told to, even the card, like we're told to imagine and to daydream and picture the images. And we're also told to be present and to be here and to walk lightly and to not, you know, miss the moments. And so it can feel like, which do I do? And how do I move between this big picture future and this current day right here that I'm in? So perhaps the clarity or the next level answer, is that how I would say it? The next level answer is, it's both, but the power is in here and today. The alignment is knowing the direction of the vision as sort of a tentative, not tentative, as a place marker in the future. Yeah, that feels more clear to me. Like being here, having the big picture, perhaps this is another way to see it. Each week I usually have at least one morning where I sit for a few hours and journal and sketch and meditate and allow myself to tap into that big picture vision. And I usually listen to like a Santero video because her vibration always helps me realign and stay focused on the collective energy, but through her filter, which I resonate well with her filter. I pull cards. I listen to music that always aligns me. So I have this cocoon that I can count on every week where I'm tapping into that big vision, that big picture of what it is that I am focusing on in my journey. And then I usually have a couple action steps that will come through in my writing or my journaling. Like the imagination card says, when you can quiet your mind chatter and you can harness your focus through journaling or writing or sketching, doodling, information comes through. And so I usually complete my quiet time, my little cocoon of space, I complete with a couple action steps. And then over the next week, I'm moving towards those action steps. So for example, this past week, one of the things that I realized is, you know, I've had on my to-do list this desire to take all of my Sunday meditations and make them more accessible as sort of a library, but I haven't known quite how I wanted to do it. And as I was journaling and writing, what I could see is I could group them by month. So, you know, you buy like a package of a month of meditations. And so I can start it now for April, even though I didn't get all of it done yet. But it's higher on my priority list. But I can create like a package of the meditations, and then each month they're grouped. And so that saves me the time of making four individual products for each week, and it just smooths it all out. And so that was like a huge, oh, I can do that, and it won't really take me that long to do it in the way that I see how I could get it done. I had another idea for how to streamline quietly listening. And so some of the action steps are super specific, and they're things that I can check off my list before the next week when I sit back down in my meditative space. Sometimes they're big clarifications about my vision. Like a few weeks ago when I had this idea about creating what I call global energy healing centers around the world, I literally wrote out like a whole business plan of how I would train people and how I would send the funding through, and you know what the flow of all of that would look like. And so my journal is filled with pages of like how the structure is going to take place. But if I had focused only on that, and how do I create that, and what do I do about that, and what's the next step for that, and blah, 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 right? If I was intensely trying to understand it and make it happen now, you can feel like how it squeezes, like it squeezed my body, it squeezes my flow of energy. It's like everything gets tighter and contracts in. And to me, that's like stopping the flow, is stopping the funnel of the energy. And that doesn't feel good. So it slows down the momentum towards that. And so I don't do that. I journal it. I put it to the side. I know when I need some of that information, it's written in my journal. It'll be waiting for me. And I'll just be able to go right back. And there's my business plan. As soon as the money is in the place it needs to be, here we go. You know, I won't have to write a business plan then because I already wrote it now. And so it's like the time and the sequence of things isn't linear. It isn't in a way that would be very logical perhaps to the average business person. But for me, it's all how I dip in and out of this energy with source, this unstoppable flow of the collective humanity. You know, when the inspiration comes, I capture it, I put it into wherever it needs to be, and I keep my focus on what am I doing today, and how do I keep moving forward, and what steps today feel good, and then suddenly it's tomorrow, and so here I am, it's Friday, what steps feel good today? And so it's like I'm slowly walking my way towards this grand plan, but so many other little pieces are being put in place that are like the cornerstone, the foundational blocks of what I'm building. And it is creating this bigger vision. And I can't always see how, you know, this is another place where I think we get so caught up. And I've done this many times, so many times. And I hear so many of my clients and friends saying the same thing. They're like, where is it? Why isn't it manifesting? Like, And it can be so discouraging and disheartening when we feel like we have everything we need in place and the vision isn't here yet. It hasn't become a reality. And that gap of time of it not happening yet can tank us. So hear my words, which is, it's already happening. If you have the vision, if you have this clear desire and image that you have projected out, that it's what you're moving towards, there is momentum that is going to carry you towards that. There are steps that are happening that you may not even be aware of. Like the podcast, I had no idea. And it was just somehow moving energetically exactly as I saw that it would. But I thought I would have to kind of maybe be more involved or guide it. No. There are unseen angels and technological wizards that are somehow creating algorithms that are helping do it for me. How cool is that? It's exactly the same with money. As the timing is delivered in a perfect way for these healing centers, the money will be there to support it. It's just fact. It just is. It just is. Why do we use that phrase, it just is, only for negative things? It just is for good things too. If you have this burning passion and desire of something that is going to serve yourself and so many others, of course it's going to manifest. It's part of that unstoppable life force of humanity. You came here to create and contribute that to the collective, or you wouldn't have that idea. It wouldn't have come into your awareness. And it certainly wouldn't have come into your awareness with all the detail and precision that it has. So get ready. Get ready, as Abraham Hicks says. Get ready to get ready. And trust that what is happening right now, what you are feeling and being guided to do right now, is part of the building block of that big thing that you are moving towards. So spend a little time daydreaming about this vision and writing, and when you feel inspired, put down more details. And then daydream about what it is that you most want to do this weekend and next week. And allow your soul to put some images and place markers there for you, so when they manifest, when those little things start to happen, those check marks start to, you know, be marked off your list. I didn't say that right. Like for me, I write in my journal that I'm going to create these monthly packages, or I'm going to make these adjustments to the Quietly Listening space, or, you know, like all these specific things that came in this week's quiet time. As I check those off, it's like my soul is giving me the message. My mind is following the guidance and doing the thing that came through in that quiet space. And so as I check it off, my mind and my soul synchronize even more. And they're like, oh, okay, we're listening, we're receiving, we're going to keep sending more messages because you're doing those messages. And so you're creating your own inner momentum, your own inner life force that is saying, yeah, I'm on track and I'm doing these things and I'm going to keep following the guidance. And it carries you. And you're walking lightly, and it's more fun. You're more present. And the moments seem to be more enjoyable, and delightful surprises are happening. And somehow, your life is transforming in and around you. And then there are those absolute sacred moments where you sit in your own life. You have, the only word is sacred. You have a sacred moment where you're sitting in your life and you understand how far you have come, how much you have transformed, how vibrant and alive your experience of this human journey is, and how limited and non-shiny, dull, like not so fun it was. Just a little while ago, or years ago, or most of your lifetime. I don't know what your story looks like, but when you have those sacred moments of seeing who you are now and who you were before, who you used to be, you know you're on track. You know that huge dream is absolutely possible, because look at what's already happened. Look at how much you've already shifted. Sky's the limit. Like, how far do you want to take it? It's incredible. Yeah, it's incredible. So, we're all walking lightly. We're all walking lightly. Let these moments last. They could be gone so fast. Keep walking lightly. I send you off into your weekend just filled with joy and such gratitude for this space, for you listening, for me still sitting here sharing. Episode 385. What? Who knows what we'll be talking about at episode 1000. Can you imagine that? Like, oh, maybe I need to journal about that. It's going to be cosmic and grounded. All right. Have a beautiful weekend, everyone. I will see you back here next week. Thank you for tuning in to this vibration of pure love. I invite you to join me on Sunday mornings for an hour of meditation, visualization, and energy healing, where we realign our mind-body-spirit with Gaia and Source. You can learn more at mysouljourney.com. Let's take this message of Gaia's love out into all of our relationships and communities today. So much love from my heart to yours.